ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا مولانا وبارك وسلم وسلم عليه حمد الصلاة کے بعد میرے واجب احترام بزرگ اور دوستو السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ اللہ تبارک و تعالی جل جلالہ وامن ابواہ کا اللہ تعالی ان کی بے شمار شکر ہے کہ ہمیں اشرف المخلوقات میں سے انسان پیدا فرمایا اور صرف یہ نہیں بلکہ ہمیں آقا انعامدار واجدار مدینہ فخر موجودات احمد مصطفیٰ محمد مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم کے امتی ہیں۔ تو شاعر کیا فرما رہے تھے کہ موت اس کی ہے جس سے کرے زمانہ افسوس، یوں تو سبھی آتے ہیں دنیا میں مرنے۔ مگر اسلام، اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی has created this دنیا this world in a way that it itself explains the greatness of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa. They say the time that my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam came in the dunya, that time was the best of all time. That family that was close to Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the best family from all the other Nabi's family. Which means every single thing that my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam had nisbat with automatically became great. What was the reason for that? Because our Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the reason of creation. What is Islam? Islam revolves around the love of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jiske andar muhabbat nahi uske andar kuch bhi. If you got love inside you, that love for Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, your iman is complete. Phir tum momin kehlata. I always said to them, few days we are lecturing now. We said that Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he was leaving the tent, Khaybar se jab ja rahe the, battlefield. He said, Zainab, sun lo. Aur achhi tarike se sun lo. What did he say? Listen. He said, listen carefully. What am I saying? Yani ye baat bahut zaruri hai. Kya farmaya? Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala said, Zainab, انہوں نے بھی کلمہ پڑھا، ہم نے بھی کلمہ پڑھا، وہ اور لوگ ہیں اور ہم اور لوگ۔ If you have, you have understanding of that, then you'll understand. You know, there is one type of ibadah from all the other types of ibadah. When that ibadah is reacted upon, there's absolutely no way of rejection. You'll ask yourself, yeah? You read namaz? You know your namaz is accepted? No. You don't know. Roza? Zakat? Tum apne aap ko khush kar lete hai. Namaz se khatam ho jaye to ke ya Allah main namaz pad liya, main namaz ho gaya. Apne aap ko khush kar liya. Allah ko khush kar kiya, ye bhi sabse badi baat. It is said that that type of ibadat is known as aslul ibadat. Because in that type of ibadat, there is no you, there is no me, there is no us. When you read namaz, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin, Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'in, Ihdina Sirat Al-Mustaqim. What do you say? Ya Allah, we only make your ibadat. We only ask you for help. Ya Allah, show us the straight road. To aur baat Allah ne farmaya, minan nabiyyin was siddiqin was shuhada'i was salihin. To aur baat. But the point is that every single dua you make, you're making either for yourself, for somebody, or for everybody. But this type of ibadat is that type of ibadat which has no rejection. And you're not saying, Ya Allah, I. You're not saying, we. We're not saying, you. What type of ibadat is that? Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has stated, قال رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم ذكر الأنبياء من العبادة. الله صرف نماز پڑھنا عبادت نہیں ہے, صرف روزہ رکھنا عبادت نہیں ہے. اصل العبادت کیا ہے؟ The reality of your عبادت is the ذکر of نبی مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. Why? Because it's the greatest gift. See Allah, why? What is that type of عبادت? See, Ya Allah, when a Sahabi came to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, Abu Sahab read a share today. Say, tu zinda hai wallah, tu zinda hai wallah, tu zinda hai. Ya Allah, Hazrat ke share. Woh kaise? He says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we make that astral ibadat, that type of ibadat which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes himself, باقی کو چھوڑو, کیا اللہ نماز پڑھتا ہے؟ بولو. نہیں. روزہ رکھتا ہے؟ نہیں. روزہ رکھ سکتا ہے؟ رکھ تو سکتا ہے. You can keep fast, don't need to keep fast. You can read نماز, don't need to read نماز. You can read کلمہ, go fast. Everything Allah is قادر, قادر مطلق ہے. But Ya Allah, what is that type of ibadah that you do? Ya Allah, we sleep, we feel sleepy, we are ghafil of that time. But Ya Allah, what ibadat you are doing? Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, send durood and salam. When you send durood and salam, what are durood and salam? Allahumma salli ala sayyidina wa maulana Muhammad. What do you say? Ya Allah, I'm sending? No. Say, Ya Allah, you send durood and salam. You're not saying you are sending. You're not saying we are sending. You're not saying all of us are sending. You say, Ya Allah, you send durood and salam. So Allah ne kya farmaya? Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. And before you can be born to us, sending durood and salam upon Nabi Mustafa.
Subhanallah.
Sahabi asked, Ya Rasulullah, sallallahu ta'ala alayka wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, when you leave the dunya, leave the world, and when somebody sends durood and salam to you, اس نے بہت پیاری بات کی. درود پڑھنے سے ثواب ملتا ہے اور سلام کرنے سے جواب ملتا ہے. فرمایا, تو زندہ ہے واللہ, تو زندہ ہے واللہ. صحابی یا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, when anyone send you درود and سلام, جب اس دنیا میں نہیں, کیا آپ سنتے ہیں؟ آپ یا رسول اللہ, you give جواب. The words of the حدیث, authentic حدیث, absolutely no doubt in the hadith. My Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam farmaya, Ki Allah, when a person sends durood and salam to me, Allah returns the soul of Muhammad into the body of Muhammad, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will give the jawab.
Subhanallah. Nani takbir.
Jo lakir ke fakir hai, farmate hai na, jo bina iske Nabi se padhte hai Bukhari. They use the same hadith and say, no, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is dead. I'll explain to you that. About zaruri baat. Every single one of us want to know. Half the people saying is they're dead, half of them saying is alive. Ye baat kya is tarah? Now he said, O Sahabi, when a person sent durood and salam to me, Allah returns the soul of Muhammad into the body of Muhammad, so Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will give the jawab. فرمایا, دیکھا حضور نے خود فرمایا, what is death? I explained to you before, what is death is when the soul is out of the body. اس کو مرنا کہتے ہیں. Soul is one side, body is one side. So Allah still gonna put the ruh inside the body again, so that man is dead. کہنا مطلب یہ ہے کہ وہ مرا ہوا. But if you understand the hadith properly, you will come to realize that Allah, number one, has created this whole dunya, this whole world, in such a way. Abhi hum namaz ya isha pad rahe hain na, dusre mulk mein fajr pad, dusre mulk mein zohar pad. When there is no one, no second, there is no minute, there is no hour, where somebody is not saying durood and salam to Nabi Mustafa. Kya farmate hai Imam Shafi? Jisne namaz mein durood aur salam nahi padha, uske namaz hi fasid. Ya Allah, you send durood and salam. So we say, okay, fine. If we don't need namaz, need salat, darood and salam, we not need namaz. Ham ghafil hote, ham so jate. To Allah, phir, Allah ne farmaya, tumhe suna nahi? Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Arey, main padhta hoon. Tum so jaye to so jao. Mujhe neend bhi nahi aate. So who is reading the durood and salam continuously? Upon Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do you tell me where is the soul of Muhammad? Wallah, the soul of Muhammad is intact in the body of Muhammad. Wallah, that is why the shayr said, tu zinda hai wallah, tu zinda hai wallah. Hamare chashm e alam se chup jate. This is the maqam of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today, alhamdulillah, we are remembering that person who loved the halabay. Sahaba ikram came to Nabi alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you gave us iman. He showed us the way to Jannah. He showed us what was right, what was wrong. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what can we do for you? Then we have to say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, kulla as'alukum alayhi ajran illa muwaddada fil qurba. Say to them, I do not need anything from you, but I want to see how much love you have for those that are close to you. And wallah, those that are close to the Prophet's family, wallah, are people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let enter Jannah. وَمَنْ مَاتَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّ آلِ مُحَمَّدٍ مَاتَ شَهِيدًا وَمَنْ مَاتَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّ آلِ مُحَمَّدٍ مَاتَ مُؤْمِنًا وَمَنْ مَاتَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّ آلِ مُحَمَّدٍ مَاتَ مَغْفُورًا. That person who dies with the love of the Ahl al-Bayt in his heart, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kufur mate, wo to shaheed hai. That person who has love in his heart for the Ahl al-Bayt, the family of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he dies as a mu'min. Maghfuran. He dies as a person who has got no guna on top of him. What is the maqam of the Ahl al-Bayt? And alhamdulillah, for the kalam of my ustad, who alhamdulillah is now at the moment the 42nd descendant coming from Sayyidina Hosea Park radiallahu ta'ala anhu. That family, wallah, pure blood of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And my mother's love for them, wallah, was so much that each and every one of them, today, alhamdulillah, Naib Ghawse Azam, Sayyid Haseenuddin Shah Sardar al Barakatuhu al Aliya, is still hayat. And wallah, he phoned me twice then, to ask what happened, how's things, what's going on. The son phoned twice. The other son, they phoned twice. And these are not normal people, wallah. I've seen with my own eyes. You know, you say a magician can make a man fly. Maine apne dono aankhon se dekha. This is the maqam of the Ahl al-Bayt. That is why he said, kabhi kabhi nazar ka maqam jo hai ibadat se bhi badh jata hai. Kabhi suna? Just by looking, kisi ko dekhna, by looking at somebody is more greater than making ibadat. Suna kabhi? Log sochenge yaar, dekhna aur ibadat, isme kaun si farq hai? They say that person who is a Sahabi, can anyone reach the rank of a Sahabi? Go and make ibadat from now till Qiyamah. You will never reach the rank of a Sahabi. You can be the greatest wali of this dunya. You won't even come close. They say the misal is this. There is a Sahabi riding a horse. And the dust that comes out from the hooves of that horse, there is no wali of this time can even reach the dust that comes out from the hooves of the horse of his Sahabi. And what is a Sahabi? Is that person who saw Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, फिर तो उन लोगों के साथ क्या कहेंगे जिनको हुजूर सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम ने खुद अपने आंखों से देखा? You look at Nabi alayhi salatu wasallam, he became a Sahabi. But when the family of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam look at you with love for Allah, you become clean, shaffaf, ready for Jannah. Ye wo maqam. And for a sahab, for a person from the family of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, remember someone who Allah is a very great thing. And I can promise you, Allah, after that call, I knew in my heart that I'm going to Jannah be. Because that family, wallah, is a family that's Aulad al-Nabi, Aulad al-Ali, wallah. They walk, they talk. Every single action of theirs are an encyclopedia of the Quran. Because they follow the Prophet Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam words right till the end. Up to this point, that millions and millions of rands goes through his hand. But wallah, when we went to see where he sleeps, wallah, he sleeps on the floor. That maqam. But he sleeps on the floor. That humility. You know when a bird, it flies outside, but his wings out, stretched out. Like you want ghanja bata, he brings his wings together like this. And like that also, our Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam given us ta'aleem. When it comes to your mother or your father, your respect, Allahu Akbar. You see, the ayat of the Quran is, وَلَا تَكُلْ لَهُمَا أُفِّنْ. That word uff, you know what the actual meaning of uff is? You know when a fly sits on you, and you make dusra ko suna bhi nahi. You can't even make that kind of sound in front of your father and mother. Where all your ibadat, all your sawab will go. And yet the dua can make you become a neighbor of Musa alayhi salam. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. One day he was climbing up the mountain. Kohetur. Say, Ya Allah, I want to see you. Say, you want to see me? Come to Kohetur. Then pass Adam. Musa al Islam is climbing one day. Allah says, Ya Musa, be careful. Don't fall. Go a few steps more. Ya Musa, be careful. Ya Musa, be careful. Upar aa gaya tha. Ya Allah, so many years of climbing up this mountain. मैं कभी किसी दफा मुझे नहीं कहा कि यार समा क्या नो वॉच एंड कम सी या मूसा व्हाट यू नो दैट पर्सन वाज सिटिंग एंड मेकिंग दुआ फॉर यू उसका काम हो गया सी योर मदर वाज सिटिंग एट होम दैट वाज मेकिंग दुआ फॉर यू एवरी डे दैट आई डिडंट नीड टू टेल यू बी केयरफुल टुडे अल्लाह हैज टेकन इट टेकन इट सो इट मींस माय ब्रदर्स इन इस्लाम द मकाम ऑफ अ मदर एंड अ फादर इज अ वेरी हाई मकाम समटाइम्स यू डोंट नो व्हाट यू विल से दैट यू विल हर्ट एंड देयर इज नथिंग यू कैन डू अल्लाह. There is no ibadah, there is no dua you can make that you can ever fulfill that which your mother has done for you. That haq, you can never do it. Look at Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. People are saying today that milad al-Nabi ya ki shirk hai, ye bidat hai, ye hai, wo hai. But look at that hadith when Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was sitting there in the Kaaba. There sahaba ikram said, Jaleelul Qadr sahaba, Abu Bakr Siddiq, Umar Farooq, Usman Ghani, Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala, all sitting. And then Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam sees a woman walking and coming towards him. Huzur sallallahu alayhi wasalam khade ho. Stood up. Took out his shawl, put it down on the floor. And he stood as if he was standing in salah. So kya kahenge salah? Jab hum kabar ko chumte hai, wo kehte hai sajda hai. Jab namaz ki tarah khada ho jayenge, wo kya kahenge? Namaz hai. Kisi ki izzat karna, ye bhi badi baat. He stood up. And the greatest form of izzat and respect is to stand up with your hands folded. Isse bada koi kaam nahi. Huzur sallallahu alaihi wasallam khade ho gaye, aise paan diye. Sahaba ikram wondering, who is this person? She came, she sat down. Nabi alayhi salatu wasallam sat down. Ye kiske zamane mein? Ye huzur ke zamane mein. Huzur ne farmaya ke, ae Halima! Zara inko mere paidaish ke bare mein batao. Ae Halima, tell them! About my birth, how I was born, and how the light came inside your house, how that khushbu came into your house, how the barakat be wulid al Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam came in your house. Ye to milad hai, aur kya hai? Allah sabko hidayat naseeb farmaye. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he was praying. See, Allah was saying to him, Ya Musa, you know who's going to be your neighbor? See, Ya Allah called him. You see, a person who is working in a butcher. Ya Allah, kisai, a butcher will be my neighbor. Yaar, uske andar kya khubi hai, yaar? Chalo, dekhte, Ya Allah, let me go see what is inside. Wo karta kya? Oh, example, far, far, far. You wait to this man, keep his place. bazaar dekha. In the old days, you know, they got no fridge. They let the sheep or goat, it hangs there now. And he's selling his mouth. Bech rahe. Galiya nikal rahe. Swearing, talking to people upside down. People are paying more, they're giving a small piece of meat. Haq chori kar, Musa alayhi salam ko dekh kar kehte, yaar, ye mera mera saathi hoga. Ye. Ya Musa, la ilma lana illa ma allamtana innaka anta alimul hakim. Ya Musa, what I know, you do not know. Say, Allah, baat kya hai? Toh dekh toh sahi. He sat and he waited. Now he sees this man, now he's closing up his shop now. He looks at the sheep now, he looks at the sheep of gold, he looks at the best piece, he cuts a nice big piece up. So Musa dekh raha tha. Say, whole day I now eat. Shayad mere liye kaat raha. Khush ho gaye. Chalo bhai, you want to spend time with me? Chalo, let's go home, we went home now. Ghar pahunche. Went home, he said, ya Musa, you sit here. Main aata hu. He goes in the kitchen, he cuts that meat nicely, he makes nice cooked meat. Get the smell, Musa toh khush ho gaye. Mera kaam hoga. When he bring the food and coming, he said, ya Musa. Pehle unki baari hai jo kamre mein. Baad mein aapki. He goes inside. It's an old lady. Buri aurat baithi. Now he takes that meat, he puts it in his mouth, he makes, crushes it, makes it soft. Old lady got no teeth, dampening it. And then he makes it soft, he takes it and puts it in his mother's mouth. Well, cut here, nicely she eat, full stomach, make her sleep. After that he comes and says, ya Musa, ab hamari bari hai, hum khaye. Dono khaya, both of them ate, they slept. To Musa alayhi salam, raat ko, ek do baje usko, kuch awaaz nazar hai. Awaaz, awaaz hai, kahan se aa raha hai? He woke up. Stories here, who's like crying so late in the night? He goes close and he sees, ya Allah, he sees this lady sitting there. He says, ya Allah, mere bete ke gunah ko na dekho. Mera beta hai gunah ka. Uski gunah ko na dekho. Ya Allah, mere safed balo ko dekho. Ya Allah, mere safed balo ko dekho. Look at the white hair I got. Ya Allah, to the sadaqah and wasila of this white hair, keep, make my son the neighbor of Musa alayhi salam. Look, kab samajh mein aaya. Ya Allah, a mother's dua, maa ki dua, jannat ki hawa. The dua of your mother, no matter how much of guna you made in this world, even through this sadaqah, Allah will give you. If you have mothers, my brothers, now my advice to you is look after them, because that is where your decision comes from. And in today's time, Allah, we're going the opposite way. Where the ta'lim of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where is our amal today? Why are we saying we are lacking today? For what? आप कहते हैं वी आर डाई हार्ड सुन्नी वी आर डाई हार्ड दिस वी आर अरे कुछ अमल तो करके दिखाओ व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सुन्नी आर यू पुट योर मदर एंड फादर इन होम्स ये सुन्नी आदमी के सुन हो चुका है मां बाप है इफ दे थॉट दैट यू विल हेल्प देम यू नो वन डे ही सेड दैट वन मैन केम ही सेड यू नो यू नो इट्स माय माय फादर यू नो ही इज वरिंग मी टू मच से क्या हुआ सी नो यू नो आई गॉट सम एक्सपेंसिव थिंग्स देयर इन द वार्डरोब Now you want to kick it and play with it. Uska umar zyada ho gaya, wo tod tod denge. Yeah, I didn't give him. Maine usse pucha, yaar, mujhe batao, when you were small and you broke the toys he gave you, he bought another one and gave you another. Yeah, usne baat kar diya. You worry about him breaking the thing that you have. When that father of yours or that person or that mother of yours, 10 times you break it, 10 times you give it to him. Ye mohabbat ki intiha hai. और वो मोहब्बत अल्लाह ने डाला वो मोहब्बत अल्लाह ने आपके अंदर पैदा किया ना रिस्क के हदीस है रिस्क का वो ईमान वन मोर पॉइंट इंशाल्लाह इन आखिरी शॉट मां की मोहब्बत क्या आ गया ना अल्लाह लव्स यू हाउ मच यू नो उलमा ने लिखा है कि वन ड्रॉप ऑफ लव that Allah has for his one banda, one person, any one of you, kitne bhi bura ho, that one drop of love, if you put it on a scale, is more heavier than the love that 1,000 mothers have for their children. Subhanallah. Ye kya maqam hai? Let me show you the muhabbat of a mother. When the child is in the mother's stomach, Allah creates that love in the mother's heart. How much love? If the love is not there, the child will die. Kaun samalega isko? Nahi samal sakenge. You'll die, each and every one of us will be dead. Make shukar to your mother and father that you are alive today. And you are walking, you are eating. Where is your shukar supposed to be there first? What Allah says, if Allah had to order anyone to make sajda for anyone else besides Allah, he would have made falls upon the men to make such, the woman to make such for the men. Why? Because they make that mahal. Yes, a woman can make that house into Jannah, and she can make it Jahannam. But what is your role? To make sure she follows upon the Sunnah of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Now when you look at Iman, you look at Muhabbat, and you look at love. And then coming to what we believe, which is known as Islam. قال قال رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده. بعض من الكلام. Authentic hadith. Absolutely no doubt. Bukhari Sharif hadith. You know what is Bukhari Sharif hadith? Every single hadith that Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi got, he made special ghusl. Special turak and nafil namaz. Then only he said and he wrote that hadith. Us hadith ka ye maqam. So Bukhari Sharif says that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, La yu'minu. You got no iman. La yu'minu ahadukum hatta akuna ahabba ilayhi min walid. Your iman is not complete until you have love for me, yani Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, more than your parents. For why Allah said parents? Why Allah never say fil ardi? Why Allah never say your work, your house, your car? Allah said you must have more love than what your parents have for you, or you have for yourself. More than that. So you ask yourself that love who created? Let's look at the hadith again. So Allah is saying through His Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your iman is not complete until you have love for me, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, more than the love that Allah has created in your body for your own family, your own children, and everything else in this dunya. Imagine the intihar that muhabbat. Why did they say, Gulam Mali Muhammad Jan, they missing the heat of the day? Yes, sir, cut jai, your reh jai, koi parwani. Life is nothing, Baba. If you love to that degree, your iman is complete, your ibadat is accepted, your rosa is accepted, your hajj is accepted. Look into yourself and see where you're standing here. You're standing on the fence, you're standing inside your heart. Where are you standing, Allah? This is iman. This is Islam. If your love is not adapt to that level, not to that degree, your iman is not complete, your namaz is not accepted, your rosa is not accepted, your hajj is not accepted. Where is your muhabbat life? May Allah give us all the hidayah to act upon the sunnah of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, so that he can make our iman to that level, wallah, where each and every practice of ours is accepted, and to gain that access, to reach that level. The Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, every one of you are trying to love me. Janta mein kaun hoon? Tune kabhi mujhe dekha hai? Mujhe to nahi dekha. You have to love Allah. How are you going to love Allah? You saw him. Dekha bhi nahi. What Allah says? Ya Allah, we want to love you. Kul in kuntum tuhibbuna Allah. Fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah. What Allah says? You have to love me. Love my Nabi first. Why you want to love me? I love you automatically. That is how beloved Allah's Rasul is to you. Allah, Allah hai, Nabi, Nabi hai. Nabi khuda nahi, lekin khuda se juda bhi. May Allah give us all the hidayah for that, and all the sahaba. Allah, send to my mother, inshallah. May Allah give us Jannatul Firdaus, and all the other marhumin, inshallah. May Allah give them also Jannatul Firdaus, and to the sadaqa and wasila of the durood and salam of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa, sallallahu ta'ala alayka wa sallam, which will read now. Give all our marhum and maqfoor Jannatul Firdaus, inshallah. In Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi, ya ayyuha allazeena amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina mawlana Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina mawlana wa barik wa sallim wa sallim alayhi wa ma alayna illa al-balaghul mubin. Jazakumullahu khair. Sallallahu alayka. Ya, ya, ya.